Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Wealthsimple Tax to prepare your tax return. I've made another video using UFile online. If you're interested, you can take a look to see which software you prefer. At the end of this video, I'm going to compare the results I got from different software.
I always start by reviewing my notice of assessment from the previous year to see if I have any carry forward amounts. For example, unused tuition amounts or RRSP contribution limit, etc. In addition to T4, T3, T5, you may also have receipt for medical expenses, donations, or child care fees. Please keep your supporting documents for at least 6 years. The first step is to log into Wealthsimple Tax. If you don't have an account, you have to create a new account. After you log in, you can create a new file for the 2022 tax year. I personally think that it is very easy to navigate the software. You just need to answer the questions, scroll down to the next session, and keep going until you've filled in all the required information. Name, social insurance number, date of birth, etc. The net file access code is an 8-character code located on your notice of assessment. It is intended to be used as an extra level of security. If this is the first time you file your tax return, you don't have to enter this. This field is optional. Next, enter your address and phone number. Then enter your province or territory of residence on December 31st, 2022. We'll use Alberta as an example for this video. If your province or territory of residence has changed in 2022, you have to enter the date of your move. Is your home address the same as your mailing address? In which province or territory do you currently live in? The next question is, did you become a resident of Canada immigrant for income tax purposes in 2022? It is important to recognize that residency status for income tax purposes is not the same as residency statuses for immigration purposes. This question is related to residency status for income tax purposes. Generally, a newcomer becomes a resident of Canada for income tax purposes when they establish significant residential ties in Canada. If you become a resident of Canada for income tax purposes in 2022, you need to enter your date of entry and your income earned while you were a non-resident. The income earned as a non-resident before moving to Canada is non-taxable, except for income you received from Canadian sources. Income earned as a non-resident is required to calculate certain benefits and credits. If you are not sure about your residency status for income tax purposes, I would recommend you to please consult with a professional. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to answer no for this question. Next, enter your marital status and whether you want to prepare your tax returns together. If you have a spouse or common law partner, and whether you have any dependents. There are benefits for preparing your tax return, and your spouse or common law partner's tax return together, as it will be easier to optimize the tax credits. If you would like to prepare your tax returns together, choose yes, enter a name for the profile, click create and link, and click OK. Next, we have to answer some CRA questions. Did you own any specified foreign property in 2022 with a total cost over $100,000? If the answer to this question is yes, or you're not sure, I wouldn't recommend you to do your tax return yourself, especially if this is the first time you're doing it yourself. This is because the rules for foreign property T1135 reporting are very complex. Did you sell a principal residence in 2022? Are you filing an income tax return for the first time? Answer all the questions in this session. Basically, these are just yes or no questions. For the purpose of the climate action incentive payment, we also have to specify the area that we live in. For the email notifications from the CRA, if you prefer to receive your notifications and documents through email, you can sign up here. If you still prefer to receive a paper notice of assessment or notice of reassessment, then you can choose no. For the CRA autofill my return, if you have a CRA my account, then this function allows you to download the information that the CRA has available so that you don't have to enter all the information manually. If you're using this service, it is still important to double check the information with your supporting documents just to make sure that all the information is downloaded properly and completely. The CRA does not have all the information. For example, donation receipts, medical expense receipts, home office expenses receipts, etc. You will still need to enter this manually. Next, I'm going to go to the spouse or common law partner session and answer the questions. After we enter the basic information, now it is time to enter the information on the tax slips and supporting documents. To add income tax forms, deductions, or credits, we just need to type the name in the search box. For example, T4, T5, RRSP, etc. Now let's add a T4. We need to enter all the information on the T4 tax slip, including employer's name, income, province or territory of employment, your CPP and EI contributions, etc. Once you are done entering all the information, double check the information just to make sure that you enter everything accurately. If you have more than one T4, you can click add another T4. Next, we'll add a T5. Let's go back to the search box and type T5. On the investment income T5. Again, enter the information here as per your T5 tax slip. I entered $500 in box 13, which is interest income. If it is a joint account, you have to put in the percentage that you are entitled to. If you have more than one T5, click Add Another T5. Next, we'll enter the RRSP information. Let's go back to the search box and type RRSP. For the RRSP, you have to enter your deduction limit for 2022. You can find this information on your 2021 assessment. I'm just going to assume that my deduction limit was $5,000 and the contribution that I made in 2022 was also $5,000. Choose the type of your contribution. Enter a description and the amount. You can choose whether to use all of your RRSP deduction in 2022 or save all or some to future years. For this example, I'm going to use all the deductions in 2022. Next, we'll look at employment expenses. Say I worked from home for 100 days in 2022 due to COVID-19 and I met the CRA criteria for using the temporary flat rate method to claim home office expenses. Go to the search box and type employment expenses. Choose I worked from home due to COVID-19. And you can choose whether you want to use the temporary flat rate method or the detailed method. For this video, I'm going to choose yes. Then I can enter the number of days worked from home. For 2022, you can still claim $2 for each day you worked from home. The maximum number of working days you can claim is 250 days, which means the maximum deduction is $500. If you have a lot of eligible expenses, you may be better off to use the detailed method. This method is more complicated. Also, you must have the form T2200S or T2200 from your employer. I've another video about this. If you're interested, you can find the link in the description. Next, we'll look at medical expenses. We'll go back to the search box and type medical. And choose medical expenses. To qualify for the medical expenses tax credit, generally, your medical expenses must be more than the lesser of 3% of your net income or a dollar limit, which is $2,479 in 2022. If you're not sure, just enter all of your expenses into the software. It will determine whether you are eligible for the medical expense tax credit. In the medical expenses section, specify the person who incurred the expenses. Enter a description. Choose the type of expense and enter the amount of expense. If you have more than one expense, click Add Another Expense. Finally, we'll look at donations. In the search box, we'll type donations. click Donations and Gifts. Choose the recipient. Enter a description and the amount. If you have any unused donations that were carried forward from prior years, you can enter it here as well. And if you donate any capital or depreciable property in 2022, you can specify it here as well. If you have a spouse or common law partner and you would like to prepare your returns together, you can enter their information. I'm going to switch to Finn's profile. The questions are basically the same. Okay, I've entered all the basic information and answered all the CRA questions. Next, I'm going to add a T4. Once you have entered all the tax slips and information, click Review and Optimize to see if there are any warnings or suggestions that we need to address. The software optimizes the tax credits for you. If you would like to override some of the allocations of the tax credit, you can manually adjust the numbers in this session. Review the information to ensure everything has been entered correctly. Based on the information entered, the software automatically calculates the refund or balance owing. One question I frequently got from client is whether the result would be the same if we use a different software. To demonstrate this, I've entered the same information in UFile, and as you can see, the results are the same. The total combined refund is $2,255 for this example. Finally, we'll look at how to submit the return. At the time I'm recording this tutorial, NetFile is not open yet for the 2022 tax year. I'm going to go to the 2021 tax year to show you how to submit your tax return. You can click Save PDF to save a copy of the return for your records. When you're ready to file your tax return, click Submit Tax Return. You have to do this separately for each of the individuals you need to file a tax return. You get a confirmation number from the CRA. Please keep this for your record.
Thank you so much for watching. Have fun filing your tax return.